Hi, I'm Andrew Berman from the Mortgage News Network, coming to you from the MNN Studios here in New York. You're watching a video press release, and with me today, I've got Carl White from Mortgage Marketing Animals and the star of Quick Hits on MNN. Carl, thank you so much for joining us.
Man, I'm excited to be here, and I'm also excited to announce season two of the Quick Hits. Thanks to you guys.
Listen, we are blessed actually to have you a part of our network. I know our viewers have felt blessed that, you know, we get some amazing feedback. You know, the things that you share in those short, 3 to 6, 7 minutes is just so powerful. I mean, you talked about this idea of creating a show where you can give quick hits that people can do things today so they can bring in more loans this month or next month. And man, Carl, you just hit it out of the park and you did exactly that.
Well, I appreciate that. Yeah, the idea behind these quick hits is like let's not talk theory, even though that's good. Let's not talk motivation, even though that's good. Let's talk about specific actionable items that you can easily do right now and get results of more closed loans or automating the process to get more closed loans while getting more time off. I mean, the bottom line, you know, I just got a real passion I got a friend of mine that says you want to do ELF marketing, ELF, which is easy, lucrative, and fun. Easy, lucrative, and fun. And the mortgage industry, I'm telling you, and I've done it both ways, right? I've grinded it out. Man, that's no fun. And I found that when I did it easy, lucrative, and fun, that I got even more results and had more time off and spent more time with my family and helped more family move into houses and more loan officers help more families move into houses and have the same thing. So you do not have to grind this stuff out to get epic results. And I know like last season, we talked about some of the things we talked about was like the 22 things that your assistant must do. How do you market to your past database to get like loans like right now? We talked about how to qualify your agents, you know, to make sure that as you're marketing to referral partners, to make sure that they have enough business going on that the efforts that you're using actually get results. Because you can have the best strategy in the world, and if you're marketing to agents that don't have a lot going on, it's not that they don't want to refer to you; they don't have any clients to. So, how do you qualify these? How do you find qualified? How do you get these qualified agents to want to send their referrals to you? And we also talked about one of my favorites was the 9-word text and or email to send out. We have never had somebody send out this email and this 9-word text and not get leads and closing. I've never heard one person say, hey, I sent it out, goose egg. I've never had that happen, not once. In fact, we just had, I think it was RJ Baxter just sent it out. And I think he said he got like, and this is just off the top of my head, I think it was like 11 loans coming in from just a simple 9-word text going out. And we've heard it over and over and over. So I'm really excited to now go into another season with even more ideas.
Yeah, listen, I mean, and all of your ideas to date, and I want to ask you about this, what you have for next season, because I can't imagine you have more ideas, but I know you do. But the thing that I really love about it, these are things that cost no, or maybe a couple of pennies, to implement these. I mean, like things like
these are not big dollar items. So this, yeah. We're talking about sending out a text, right? I mean, how much does that possibly cost? But you know, the other thing that we cover, which is equally important, I think, is loan officers get so busy doing the loan chasing, condition chasing and putting out fires and everything, they don't have time to send out the 9-word text. And so this season coming up, we're gonna be going even deeper into how do I get help, even if I think I can't afford it, how do I get help to do some of that activity that keeps me from sending out these text to get even more loans? Because a lot of people, they equate more loans with more work and more headaches, and they're going, look, I already got enough headaches. I want more money, but I don't want the more headaches that in the past they've associated with more loans. And we're going to go even deeper how to keep that from happening. And we're also, I'm going to spend a lot more time on the upcoming episodes on going into what I call the online offline. And so there's a lot of loan officers that are saying, hey, the offline is where it's at, phone calls, meetings, teaching classes, you know, the old blocking and tackling, and it's great stuff. And it is, it's great stuff.
Yeah.
And then there's another part of another side of loan officers that they only do the online stuff. And they say, hey, if you're still doing the phone calls and the meetings, you're riding a horse and buggy. You need to be doing, you know, Facebook and LinkedIn, the social marketing, YouTube and the ads. And they're right. They're both good. I don't know of any other person, any other trainer that is showing how do we incorporate the online and the offline. So it's kind of like the Reese's peanut butter cup where, you know, we put the chocolate and the peanut butter and it's even better than the two combined is way better than separated. So it's kind of like a 1 + 1 = 18 kind of thing. So we're going to be going a lot deeper into that. And we're also on the online, we're going to be talking about what I call the bigger cup. It's never been easier to write more loans in areas outside your own area. So a lot of our loan officers are, you know, they're doing pretty good in their little area,
yeah.
But it's never been easier to expand out of your area to get even more loans coming in because and doing that through a combination of the online offline techniques and to attracting a larger crowd from a larger area. And if you get a bigger spear to, you know, if you're fishing from a bigger lake, you're going to get a bigger catch. I mean, that's just how it works. So I'm really excited about that too.
Yep. The philosophy I know you've shared with me once is, you know, where you take a map and put a cup around it. Just get a bigger cup and go.
Yeah,
actually,
just get a bigger cup. And it's never been easier. And I found that it's never been the public and the referral partners have never been more open to getting people from outside of their area. Because, I mean, let's face it, when they're using, say, Quicken, right, they know that Quicken's help, they're not even in their same state, right? Yeah. The person answering the phone might not even be in this country, and people have become accustomed that they're okay with that. Yeah. And so the idea that we can only market in our own little town, we're going to totally blow that out of the water and really show people how to market to a larger area using automated technology and combining it with some of the offline stuff, but which is making relationships with those people. Just how do you do it? Like with Zoom meetings, like what we're doing right now.
Yeah, so Carl, one thing and we didn't talk about this before we went on camera, and I probably should have before I just kind of slapped you with this. But you know, and I don't know if people realize this, but you're actively originating. So these aren't like, you know, in theory that you've seen people do this. Like you've actually done these things.
So I'm a current. I've got a unique situation, but I'm a branch manager, a mortgage branch manager, and I've got. I call it my umbrella. Of these satellite branches that we have too, and I think last month I don't have the exact number, but give or take, I think I got paid on I think it was like 450 loans last month.
That's insane.
And so yeah, and I can everybody that's in the organization, it's doing these strategies that we're talking about. So this isn't stuff that worked like 10 years ago or 15 years ago. This is what we're using in our branch today. We just had our record month this last month, most amount of loans we've ever closed ever. And while a lot of people are kind of struggling. And so, this is very relevant stuff. It's actually working and it's giving us record numbers.
But can I ask you this? So why? Why do you share? So you have such success within your own organization, which you know you don't really talk about that much, and I appreciate you sharing that with me. But you know, why do you share all these concepts and ideas? You know, that are just doing unbelievable. You know, with let's call a spade a spade. This is being used by your competitors in your markets that you're competing. So what is the reason that you do that?
So I'm sitting here looking. So this is going to sound corny, and I didn't know you was going to ask this question. So this is not a prepared answer. No. But this is a big deal for me. So it's going to sound corny, but I mean it from the bottom of my heart. I love helping other people. So I found I can have epic results in my branch. And while sharing these ideas, other loan officers around the country can also. And it doesn't take away from me. It adds to me. I have that abundance mindedness. Mm-hmm. And I've always thought, you know, people that try to hide everything, it's a scarcity mindset. and a scarcity mindset will give you a scary business. I'm going to tell you that right now.
That's
so
great.
I'm going to tell you, a day doesn't go by literally, and I'm sitting here looking at my phone as I'm doing this. Literally, I just had a message sent from James Harper, right? He's somebody that utilizes some of the strategies we give. And he just sent me a picture of him and his buddies out of Panama City. And I think he made a 3-day weekend out of it. So instead of sitting and grinding it out on a Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, he's having epic results in his business. And he sent me a picture where him and his buddies are out on Panama City Beach. And brother, I get pictures of they're hanging out with their buddies, people hanging out with their kids or their wives or their husbands or their boyfriend or their girlfriends or just by themselves going for a nice taking a week vacation. I just got a message from Suzanne Downs. She's in the British Virgin Islands as we speak right now for the last week. Just finished one of her best months ever. Like serious, like just enormous. And I live for these. I call them my love notes. I live for these love notes. And I know that sounds corny. And don't get me wrong, I get paid for what I do, and I appreciate that. But that's not the driving force. I get paid in the mortgage business too, and I get paid very well in that. So it's just, I just love helping other people, and I love the love notes that I get from them. So it's at the stage of the game I'm at now, it truly is more about the legacy and helping more people and having a bigger impact. And it sounds corny, but that's the honest to gosh truth.
Yeah, no, it does sound corny, but I know it's gospel coming from you. There's no question about it. You've impacted the lives of countless mortgage professionals, not just financially, but from a lifestyle perspective. So, Carl, thank you so much. So excited for season two of Quick Hits. Thank you so much, Carl.
Well, you guys bring so much to the industry. Man, any way I can help you guys out, it's an honor to be playing in your sandbox. And you guys have been a huge influence on me. And the other individuals that you have, I'm not going to name them because I might miss somebody, but the other individuals that you have that share ideas, they're all, as far as I know, they're all personal friends of mine and just amazing ideas from everybody that you guys. So you guys are an attractor that has brought an amazing pool of talent that's openly sharing ideas. And I appreciate what you do, my brother.
Fantastic. All right, Carl. Thank you so much. And I'm Andrew Berman from the Mortgage News Network. Thank you for watching.